Okay, so coming back to this, the last session for today. So I'll request all of you to please switch off your tutorials. We will have a look at the other part of Scilab. I don't know if you have listened to the XCOS tutorial. Okay, so how it is related? First of all, I have a hardware in my hand. This hardware is called as a single board heater system, and this hardware was designed and developed at IIT Bombay. And we have, so what is the use of this hardware? First of all, this hardware was designed with the aim of having a plant, a portable plant. How many of you are from electrical engineering department or controls, instrumentation? Anything, electrical controls, very few, okay. But you must be aware of the terminologies such as control system, okay. Hardware access, you know, control system, hardware access, plant, process, must be aware of these terminologies. So what are others, rest, all are mathematics? Computer science. Electronics, so how many from electronics background? Okay, so you can also be counted as electrical engineering part of. Okay, so Scilab can not only be just used for plain mathematical calculations, matrix operations, but you can also very well use it, extend its usability for connectivity of a hardware, to connectivity of a hardware. So I'm here to demonstrate this feature. You see my desktop screen over there. So this device, by the way, is a Atmega 16 microcontroller based device. It has two ports for communication, serial port and USB port. The protocol itself is serial anyways, and it is powered by a usual normal household power supply. So I'll just connect this device. I'm using a USB cable, a normal USB cable. On my console, first of all, I am using Ubuntu 12.04 as the operating system. Here, I have Scilab installed in my computer. I'll start Scilab with the command sudo scilab. Now, people who have or who will be using this feature of Scilab with hardware on a Linux system with 12.04, please make sure that to start Scilab from terminal, you need to type sudo before Scilab. This is required for, you know, the newer operating systems of Linux, because if you don't type sudo, it doesn't give you the root access. Now, why do you need a root access? Why? Because you are talking to a hardware, and there should be enough permissions to, you know, go to the kernel level and to the hardware level. There should be enough permissions. So I will type sudo scilab and I'll press enter key. It will ask me for the sudo password. I'll type in the password. Okay. So now what I'll do is I have a experiment code, scilab code, in my computer. I will quickly run that experiment. So what I'll do is, like, first of all, I have connected this device to my computer. So how do I get to know if my device is getting detected, if the device has got detected? So what I'll do is, like, on Linux systems, I'll type ls/devices, that is /etyusb*. Okay. So my device is a USB device, so I should get this thing. So what I get is, like, is it visible? So what I'm getting is, like, /dev/TTY USB 0. So my device has got detected as USB 0. That's a number, serial number, 0, 1, 2, 3. If I have two such units connected, I'll get 0 as well as 1. That is /dev/TTY USB 0 and /dev/TTY USB 1. Okay. So I have to remember this number. What is the device number? Now what I'm going to do, first of all, I'll change the Scilab working directory. Okay. Why do I need to change Scilab working directory? Because I have to run some files, you know, which are on my hard drive. Okay. So for that, I have to first specify the present working directory of my Scilab. You do the same thing for MATLAB, like you first, change the working directory. So what I'll do is, my folder in which the necessary code are in step test folder. So I'll just go to that folder. I will check my present working directory by typing pwd, and it says that I'm in desktop under the folder step test. Okay, step test is the experiment name. Okay, so now I will run a file. Okay, so now I'll open a file. I will open this file which we have written a code. So what does this file do is, it will load the toolbox. Now what toolbox am I using? I am using the serial toolbox of Scilab. Okay, now Scilab, when you install Scilab, it by default it doesn't have any capability of reading or writing to a hardware device. So you need some internal links. Like, for example, you need drivers for various devices. The same way, you need some more capability added to the Scilab for it to connect to a hardware. So these are nothing but, these extensions are nothing but toolboxes. It is similar to what you do with MATLAB. So similar to MATLAB, in Scilab we have various toolboxes, of which I am using the serial toolbox. Okay. I am loading it, and you can see that here in this function I am mentioning the device number. Okay, because before starting with the communication, I should declare with what device I am communicating, because I may have multiple such devices connected. So I am saying that connect to the USB 0 device. So this is the execute button. I will execute. So on the console, I'll get a message that COM port is open. That means that the communication port is open for communication. If I had made some mistake, or the hardware is not ready, or it's not connected, it will give some other message, say the device is not connected, or any other customized message. For now, successfully, fortunately, we have this device detected and the COM port is opened. Then I will also load a function. How many of you did functions? Scripts and functions. How many of you did scripts and functions in tutorials? Right now in spoken tutorial, just two, three, four people. So you must be able to understand what I am showing here. So depending upon the experiment, I have a function written. I'm naming the function as step test. That's simply a name. And here I am writing some code within this start function and end function line. That is, function temp is equal to this and end function. Between these two lines, I am writing my entire code. Okay. So I will load this function. So it has executed the function. Now, how many of you are aware of XCOS? XCOS is, how many of you are aware of Simulink? People who have used MATLAB must be knowing. Not required, but must be knowing. So few people know what is Simulink. So Simulink is nothing but a block diagram kind of representation, a GUI to a MATLAB, you can say. And so similar to Simulink in MATLAB, we have XCOS for Scilab. Okay. So I have just started the XCOS environment, and I'll open an already made block diagram, which is again with the name step test. So I have this block diagram, XCOS block diagram. Okay. So here I have, so my experiment is what? First of all, this device, I forgot to tell you, this device has a process of heating and cooling. So in this device, I have a heater coil, then I have a temperature sensor, and I have a fan to cool this assembly. Okay, so it's a process. Something is heating, something is sensing the temperature, and something else is cooling this mechanism. So I have a process. So of which I'm allowing the user to change the value of heat, that is, change the value of current passing through the coil, heater coil. Secondly, change the speed of the fan, and the user is allowed to read the temperature. Okay, So there are two inputs to this system, the heater and the fan speed, and the resulting temperature is the output which the user will be reading from the device. So I am giving heater input, I am giving fan input, and I am taking the temperature as the output, reading from the device. So I'll just run this simulation. This is just to show you that hardware communication is also possible with Scilab. You can explore this usability in your labs, and it is quite easy to do with USB devices. Yeah. So here you can see there are three plots. These are all customized. Okay, this is not something hard coded. You can have any amount of plots, any number of plots, any kind of plots. So I have three plots as per my requirement. One is heater, the first one, fan, the second one, and temperature is the third one. Okay, so I am giving a some value of heat, the fan is constant, and the temperature is rising. See, the temperature over here, the one with the red variable, I'm not sure if it is visible for you at the last, but people over here can see it very easily. This is a value of temperature, which, so before the time zero, the device was, so what is this temperature? Why didn't it start from zero? That's the room temperature. So what was that? Around 28 was the room temperature. So then suddenly it saw a heat of 65. Suddenly it got a heat of 65 units, and you know, because of that value of heat, the temperature started rising. It is simply an experiment. It could be any experiment. So this is the, so here we have talked about the, we have saw the usability of, so I can stop this experiment by this stop button. Okay. I don't know, I don't have an internet connection right now, but so this was local access of this particular hardware device. We also have, Sir must have talked about virtual laboratory, virtual labs. So as a part of that virtual lab project, we have a virtual laboratory deployed at IIT Bombay for this particular device. What is that site, please? Yeah, I'll give you the details. So for this device, we have virtual laboratory deployed at IIT Bombay. We have around 15 such devices hosted over the internet online 24/7. So these devices are available for access, for experiment online over the web. I'll just give you the link where you can start using our laboratory. So I'll just write the site name over here. So this is the website name. That is www.co-learn.in/web-sbhs. This is the URL with which you can use this virtual lab facility. Okay, here you have to register, the documents are available, the basic files are available, even tutorials are available. So that's it about the hardware access feature of Scilab with the device. Any questions on this hardware presentation? Like how did I did something? Yes. Yeah. So the question is like the core which I have showed you, the Scilab core, that can be used as it is for any other process. Yeah, that is very true, because I am customizing my code to this particular hardware. Yeah, of course, but on this particular hardware, I can perform n numbers of experiments. See, what the point over here is like, you are communicating with the device. In this experiment, I am just passing the value of three variables, heat, fan, and temperature. The logic, like what do you want to do with these variables, sits in Scilab. Okay, so the logic part is in computer. The controller, as in, sits in the computer. The hardware, between the hardware and the computer, only the values are passed. Okay, the logic part is in the computer. The question is, if I am not mistaken, the question is, can you put the program, can you put the algorithm, the logic, or the experiment in the hardware itself? Okay, so this deals with a programming of microcontroller, if I'm not mistaken. So this deals with programming of microcontroller, and if you burn the algorithm or the experiment in the hardware, Any other question related to any topic? Spoken tutorials or Scilab or any other? We are on the verge of closing this session. So that's it for today. Thank you very much.